Hi everyone, this is Camille. We've made the tutorial showing you how to make your video feel more fun with Cutout websites. In this video, we'll be showing you how to make this text behind your person cutout effect. If you're into this topic, keep watching. In the first place, let's prepare an image or a snapshot of a video. To make this image work better with the video, we can locate the point where we want to take a snapshot. Add a marker and then click here to take a snapshot of this video. Next, we open this website. Drag our image into the website like this. After a while, we can download the image without the background. If we're not satisfied with the outcome, we can click on here to tweak the details. After that, click this button to save the cutout image. Let's go to the left top to find the titles. Select this title preset. Hit Edit Text to enter the text editor panel. Change the text content as you like. Adjust the size and the scale ratio. Also, we can spin the image a little bit. As for the color, I select a white border. Click on Apply. Drag the text clip to the blank space after the end of the video. Click here to save a snapshot. Then we click on Edit Text, changing the text color to white. Take a snapshot. That's all for editing the text. Let's add the cutout image and the two text images into VideoProc Vlogger. Find the marked point. Use the split tool to split the video over here. Then drag the saved snapshot image in between these two segments. This can make a freeze frame effect. We can adjust the length of the clip to adjust the duration of this effect. Next, let's add the white text image to the overlay track. Go to the inspector panel and select Fit to the screen height. Then we go to the blend mode section and select Linear Dodge. Now the image appears. Next, we need to add two more overlay tracks. Add the cutout image to the track and adjust the duration. We can find that some parts of the text are hidden by the man. Next, we add the white text border image into the overlay track. And just like what we already did, adjust the size and the blend mode. Now the text effect appears. Next, let's make this white border. In my case, I use a black image and the border effect. If you don't have a black image, then you can move the playhead to the end point of the video. Create a new text clip. Delete the text content. Then click on Snapshot to get a black image. Let's add a new overlay track. Add the black image to this track. Click on Crop and adjust its shape. After that, go to the upper left go to Effects and find the border. Drag it into this point. Now all these clips are added with the border effect. Let's go to the bottom of the inspector panel and find the scope. Uncheck these options other than the option of the black images. Then we adjust the size. Set it to around 2. Next, let's select the black image and change the blend mode to linear dodge. There, we need this white box appear behind this object. Thus, let's adjust their sequence. Now we make the static effect. Next, let's start making the animation effect. Let's firstly select this text clip, head motion. I want to make the text move upwards from the bottom of the screen. So I click on here and select the first keyframe. Adjust this box to make it the same size as this window. Then move the playhead to this point. Add a new keyframe. Next, let's get back to the first keyframe. Move the selection box upward. We don't need to move it to the very top. Just make sure the text doesn't show on the image and then move it a little bit. In this way, we can make the text enter the image earlier, so we have better control over the video pace. Last, we select the second keyframe, changing the speed mode to speed down. Lock other tracks and preview the video. It looks good. Next, we create the flicker effect for the text and the border. Find the point where the text stops to move. Then we select the text border image and split it into several segments, like this. Delete these segments in the middle. If the flicker effect doesn't show properly, we can make small tweaks. Let's play it and see the effect. Well, we've made the flicker effect. We can use the same method to edit the white border image. Make sure the start and end positions of these clips match with the text border clips. Let's take a preview. Well, it looks good. Finally, we can adjust the color of the freeze frame effect. Make the background look a little bit different. This can make the outcome look more artistic. Just edit according to your own preferences and the using footage. That's all for this video. Just try this effect in your video. Feel free to visit our homepage to find more tutorials for making tons of fancy effects. Be sure to click the subscribe button to subscribe if you haven't yet, so you can get notified as soon as we post any new content. See you in our next video. Hope you enjoyed it. Bye.